In this video, we're going to explore yet another problem that will ask you to find the hydrostatic force. So it's given that a dam has the shape of a trapezoid with height 80 feet. The width at the top of the dam is 60 feet and the width at the bottom of the dam is 140 feet. Find the maximum hydrostatic force that the dam will need to withstand. So first we're going to draw a picture to assist us in setting up the problem correctly. Okay, so shape of a trapezoid, the width at the top of the band of the dam is 60 feet, right? So let this be 60, and the bottom is longer, so we will have a trapezoid like this, okay? Okay, and this will be the bottom of the dam, right? So this will be 140, and I'm not drawing to scale, so keep that in mind if it doesn't look like it should. 60 on the top, right? 60, and this, the height is 80, right? Okay, let me write that clearer. 80. Okay, so in order to find the hydrostatic force, we will have to involve weight density of water, which is 62.4 pounds per cubic foot. Okay, so pounds per cubic foot. We will also need to have so what is the combined force? The maximum hydrostatic force will be the combined force acting upon all slices of the dam. And what I mean by slices is let's say I'm going to draw a slice here. Okay, that's one example slice. And as you can see, there are infinitely many slices that we can draw until we basically draw the whole trapezoid in blue, right? So this is one example slice. Okay, so when you're calculating the maximum hydrostatic force, you will take into account all the slices, and the force will be the combined force acting upon all the slices, like this one. Okay, so you will need the depth, okay, so the depth of each slice, you will need the width of each slice, and you will need the height of each slice, okay? So now let's do something really cool. Let's make this top of the dam be the y-axis, and let's make this the height of it be parallel to the x-axis. Okay, so now let's look at this example slice, because if we get all the parameters for this slice, we will be able to sum up all the slices in a similar fashion and we will find the total force. Okay, so so this is the ith slice of the dam. And now this ith slice will have its height, and you can see I can't draw this thinner, but the height is basically the vertical part of that slice, right? It will be delta x. Why delta x? Because this is parallel to the x-axis, right? Vertical distance is going to be the x values, right? That's why it's delta x. Now the width will be parallel to the y-axis, right? The width from here to here of that slice. That's the width of that particular slice. But if you're integrating, we're going to be integrating with respect to x. So that's why the width, even though it's parallel to the y-axis, must be expressed in terms of x. So we will need, so the height of the ith slice is the h. It's going to be delta x. The width of the I slice. Now, how do we calculate the width? The width will be calculated by first understanding that we're going to use an equation. Okay, so the width of the of x, width will be the function of x, obviously, right? Because it will be in terms of x, so that's why the width will be as a function of x. Now, it's convenient that we're using the x and y axis here, right? Because we can look at the top first, okay, at this point here. The width at zero, okay, when x is equal to zero, because think of it as the origin here at this point, when x is equal to zero, the width is going to be 60, right? This part. This part is 60, the top of the dam, the top of the trapezoid is 60. So width of zero is 60. However, the width as a function of x when x is equal to 80, right? Because we're moving to the bottom. So when x is equal to 80, the width is going to be 140, right? This distance. That's 140. The bottom of the dam, 140. So now, guess what? We can formulate an equation using these two points, right? Because these are ordered pairs, right? So basically what I mean is this. 0, 60, and 80, 140. You see, these are ordered pairs that we've created. This is the x, this is the width, this is the x, this is the width. Okay, so now the equation that we're going to need for the width is going to be as a function of x, as we decided, right? So we're going to use the slope first, so 140 minus 60, right? We're using the point slope form, in other words, to form the equation. 140 minus 60, the change of the vertical values. Well, in this case, it's going to be horizontal values, but it's basically the same thing, right? We're just, we know that the dependent should be on the top of the fraction. So 140 minus 60 divided by 80 minus 0, right? That's the slope. And now, so the slope will multiply x minus, and let's choose the 60. Okay, let's choose the 60 plus the width of 0. Oh, sorry, I think I did it wrong. X minus 0, actually, plus 60. Right, that makes sense. Right, because this is the independent one, it pertains to the x, and this is the width, right? So plus 60 must be added as the width after that. That's the point slope form. So now, as a result, what we get, the width as a function of x becomes, what is this? This is 80 divided by 80 is 1, right? So it's just x plus 60. So there goes your equation. This is the equation for the width. Okay? So now you found your width, you found the height. Now, one thing remains to find is the depth. So the di, the depth of this ith slice, is going to be x, right? Because this distance from the y-axis to this ith slice is going to be x. Xi, we can say it xi, okay? Xi. Well, for convenience, we can also say that this is xi as well, just so that you're not confused, okay? And keep in mind that this xi will be applicable to every single slice that we think of, okay? So the depth of the ith slice will be the xi, right? The distance from the top of the dam to this particular slice. That's xi, that's the distance. Okay, so now you found all the components for to find the force required, the force acting upon that individual slice, right? So we can label it as force subscript I is going to be 62.4 times h of I times w of xi times the di, okay? And that translates to 62.4 multiplied by, well, let's leave the delta x in the very end. Let's do w of xi, which is xi plus 60, the width function. And then finally, the depth is xi, right? So xi. And then finally, the height of the slice, which is delta x. Okay? So now if you want to combine all the forces together and make sure that you take the n to infinity, Okay, n is the number of slices, right? So n number of slices. Okay, and like I said, you want to make sure that you have infinitely many slices. And you see, it's possible because the height is so small that you can fit so many different slices like this. You will not be able to count them, right? So that's why you will take the limit to infinity as n approaches infinity, that is, and you will calculate the correct force, the exact force for all the individual forces acting upon individual slices. You will combine all these forces together to find the total maximum hydrostatic force, all right, acting on the dam. So you will take the limit to infinity. You will make sure that there are infinitely many slices. You will not be able to count them from the first slice to the nth slice, right? And you're going to do 62.4. You're going to copy this down, right? F, all the forces together, right? So basically, I'm just writing 62.4 times xi plus 60 times xi times delta x, which is basically fi, right? Well, I can write it for convenience so that you know what I'm talking about. So I'm just going to do fi, right? Which is equal to, you're summing up all the forces, right? So it's going to be n, take it to infinity, from the first slice to the nth slice. And I'm just going to replace fi with what I have here. So it's going to be 62.4 xi plus 60. Well, you know what? How about we rearrange it? We make it xi first. Let's put the xi before xi plus 60. Xi plus 60, and then delta x in the very end. Okay? So if you want to take this limit to infinity, you will approach a definite integral value, right? So we can take 62.4 out. And now, be careful how you differentiate. Notice that when you took the n, and you created the delta x, which was the height, notice that the height for each slice will be the same. That's why you divide the 80 by n equal subintervals, okay? Because if n is the number of slices, dividing 80 by n will give you the same heights for all the slices. For each slice, you will have the same heights delta x, right? So 80 divided by n is delta x. Okay, so for this reason, it will help you understand what you need to, what the limits of integration are, because you are integrating basically over the height, right? You're integrating over the height region of this dam, because you want to know what the maximum hydrostatic force that the entire dam will need to withstand, right? So you need to integrate all over all the possible slices, which is the height region from 0 to 80, right? So you have to set the limits from 0 to 80. Okay, so then 62.4 is taken out. Xi becomes x in the definite integral. Xi plus 60 becomes x plus 60. And delta x, as you famously know, is just dx, right? Okay, so then we can simplify this from 0 to 80. So we'll have x squared plus 60x dx. Okay? So now we'll have 62.4, let's use brackets, we're going to have 1/3 x to the third plus 30x squared, right? Following the power rule of the antiderivative. Okay, and this is taken from 0 to 80. Okay, so let's keep the 62.4 outside. So we will have 1/3 80 cubed plus 30 times 80 squared minus, and we're going to subtract the lower limit, which is 0, right? So we can disregard that. So we're left with 62.4. Let's see what the calculator gives me. 80 cubed divided by 3 plus 30 times 80 squared, right? That gives me 60, well, let's see, 662.6667. Multiplying by 62.4 gives me an exact work, I mean force, sorry. So that's 226304. So that gives me 22,630,400 pounds. So make sure you understand your final units for force will be pounds, because the depth, width, and height make up the feet cubed, right? Because the depth is in feet, the width is in feet, the height is in feet of each individual slice. So that's why it cancels out with this cubic foot in the denominator, and you're left with pounds for the force. It makes sense, right? So this is your final answer, 22,630,400 pounds. So this is the total, the maximum hydrostatic force that the dam will need to withstand. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video.